I didn't pay him too much. It's a tough act to follow Dr. Shafiq Qadri, very dear friend of ours, very, very proud Canadian of the, and a respectable Pakistani origin, Pakistani Canadian. Thank you, Shafiq. I'm so pleased. I'm so pleased with all of you and seeing so much. I'm extremely overwhelmed with where we are going. And I will take a few minutes to report what has happened in the past 30 years and where we would like to go forward. And I have to refer to my notes, I'm sorry, but bear with me. Thank you to one and all in the room today. Your presence is an endorsement of our collective vision promoting Canada-Pakistan trade internationally. I'd like to take this opportunity to apprise the audience about the ongoing work that your council has undertaken. My appreciation and gratitude go out to the CPBC board and advisors for their confidence in electing me as their new president. An organization of prestige, to me, it means a lot. Taking over from Andy and stepping into his shoes will not be easy. After 3 decades of hard work and profound progress, today we stand as an unparalleled platform for business collaboration between our two countries. I'd really like to express my gratitude to all our sponsors whose continued support has been a key to our success. Special thanks go out to our corporate sponsor, RBC. We are very well represented here. Thank you very much. I equally appreciate our gold sponsors, our silver sponsors, and their continued encouragement and assistance over the years. We take pride in celebrating this landmark of 30 years with the gracious presence of our very own Premier Kathleen Wynne. We look forward to a keynote address, which will surely highlight her policies as well as her outlook on trade with Pakistan. The Government of Ontario has been a consistent supporter of the CPBC, and for this we are extremely grateful. The entire CPBC team is eager to continue to fulfill the agreements of cooperation already in place between Ontario and Punjab. I was indeed fortunate to be a part of the delegation when a memorandum of understanding was signed between the provinces of Ontario and Punjab. We look forward to a prolific and successful business relationship between the two countries. Interesting, I would like to definitely mention, we approached the new Chief Minister of Punjab, Mr. Mian Shahbaz Sharif. He recently got elected, and our High Commissioner alluded to the fact that Pakistan had a very successful election, and it's onwards to a good road to democracy. On the day that he was sworn in, we approached him for a message for our gala. And within 24 hours of turnaround, we had a message in our hand. This I'm only telling you for the fact that I'm totally convinced that Punjab as a province and Pakistan as a whole is ready to do business and business with Canada. His message clearly indicates the desire to pursue various projects in Pakistan, including those related to power generation and infrastructure. This really is the time for us Canadians to take the next step and leverage our superior technology and expertise to partner with Pakistan in its journey forward. Our 30 years so far has been quite eventful and busy. We had a very productive meeting with the High Commissioner of Canada, His Excellency Greg Gyukas, before he departed for his post in Pakistan. We also had our annual spousal night last December. We dedicated this event to our outgoing president, Andy Merchant, for this excellent support and the foundation that was laid. Moving forward, I have taken it upon myself to further enhance and consolidate our already existing ties with our strategic partners, associate organizations, and stakeholders. In this matter, we have already been able to hold meetings with the Pakistan chapter of the International Chamber of Commerce, the Federation of Pakistan Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and our very own Senior Trade Commissioner in Islamabad, Mr. John Gosell. This was in March when he visited Toronto. Combining the resources of all our networks and partners, we held a successful, I would say, Focus on Pakistan seminar on May the 1st, 2013, at the International Convention Center here in downtown Toronto. This was indeed a joint coordinated effort with the DFAT and the MEDT, in addition to active participation from the EDC, the BDC, Engro Foods Canada, OMAF, and the Ontario Chamber of Commerce. The Brampton Board of Trade was a co-host for this event as a direct result of our memorandum of understanding with them. Amongst the various topics discussed were ICT education, investment, and project financing. Based on the feedback that we received, we expect to continue this series of focused workshops for each business areas discussed. As an outcome to the Focus of Pakistan seminar, we are consolidating a report that will be a guideline for us and for our business partners to capitalize on the commercial opportunities at hand. Additionally, a specialized report on information and communication technology has been created by one of our members, Ali J. Rana, with inputs from industries both here and in Pakistan. These documents will be available shortly to the public. I am quite happy to recognize the presence of Jeffrey Jones, Senior Trade Commissioner here in Toronto, the Department of Foreign Affairs, for extending their support in achieving this. I, of course, also definitely want to acknowledge the presence and support that we continue to receive by Mr. Akhil Tyagi, somewhere right there, who generously shares his expertise in the flow of international trade to and from Canada. The presence of Mayor Fennell and many, many representatives of the Brampton Board of Trades and other executives is clearly an endorsement and assurance that we are ready to enhance trade ventures. Thank you. You're okay to clap, okay? To further expand trade opportunities, a working committee has been created to identify opportunities and to devise solutions to challenges. The strong support of Pakistan Consulate and the FPCCI has been invaluable in this initiative. Looking forward, we are excited to work with the new Consul General, Mr. Mohammad Nafi Zakaria. In fact, the CPBC is definitely fortunate to be as a recognized organization at all levels of the government in Pakistan and Canada. I would like to mention we appreciate the encouragement from Prime Minister Stephen Harper, in addition to all the leaders who have sent us congratulatory messages. Definitely take 30 seconds to recognize Mr. Moizuddin Ahmed, the country manager for PIA. Thank you for their support in providing specialized subsidized tickets for a special recipient of a very important award that you will be seeing in a short while. The year holds much promise for our countries. As the incoming president, I continue to pledge, fulfill the mandate of the Council and strive to maintain the CPBC as the go-to organization for establishing trade between Canada and Pakistan. As the scope of our trade continues to expand, I hope to see continued gains in agriculture and technology and a stronger focus on education, healthcare, and all these areas that will cement the foundation of future prosperity. We have paid tribute to Fahim. Salma mentioned about it. We will do that in the later part of the evening as well. Before ending, I'd like to express our wholehearted congratulations to all the award nominees and winners here tonight. Last, but not the least. I'd like to thank all our volunteers and their help for putting this wonderful event together. Thank you. Let me finish by using the motto that I used when I was the president of the Rotary Club of Richmond Hill. Ladies and gentlemen, together we can make a difference. Thank you.